Hi, I'm Roger Hunter, Chief Technology Officer at QTS Capital Management. I was the founder and former CEO of a scientific software firm that was sold to Thomson Reuters. I was also a professor of mathematics at New Mexico State University. After completing this course, you'll be able to 1. Explore price and volume data to resolve issues with outliers, duplicate values, multiple stock classes, survivorship bias, and look-ahead bias. 2. Work with sentiment data to identify structural breaks and to aggregate categorical features. 3. Examine fundamental data and resolve multiple data merging issues. 4. Create features and target variables for machine learning models. This course will provide you with all the essential skills required to check and rectify financial market data and to create the right features and target variables for machine learning algorithms. The course has two parts. The first part is about financial data science, and the second part is about feature engineering. In the financial data engineering part, we will walk you through several different data sets and the challenges they present. The first data set you start exploring is price and volume data. You'll learn to identify and solve problems such as survivorship bias, redundant stock data, multiple stock classes, and outliers. Then you'll learn to perform checks in sentiment data derived from news items. The sentiment data you'll study contains sentiment score, class, and category for each news item. You'll learn to aggregate numerical and categorical data and how to deal with repeated news. There can also be structural breaks in the data, which will be illustrated with the help of an example. Next, you'll work with fundamental data. Anything to do with the business of the company, such as earnings, revenue, profit, and expenses, is considered fundamental data. In this section, you'll start by examining the data and then deal with the problem of merging fundamental data from different vendors. The final data engineering task will be to explore look-ahead bias in futures data using a calendar spread strategy. This is where we begin the feature engineering part of the course. Most of the available financial data is time series, and a very common time series type is time bars. In time bars, market data is sampled at a fixed time interval. You'll learn the limitations of time bars and how to create alternative bars such as tick, volume, dollar, and information bars. These can be valuable features for input to machine learning algorithms. However, machine learning algorithms work best with data where properties such as mean and volatility don't change in the long term. Such time series data is called stationary. You'll learn about methods to ensure these bars and other time series data is stationary. So far, everything I've discussed has been about the input. However, to train a model, we need outputs, also called labels or targets. But is it straightforward to set the targets? Unfortunately, no. In the labeling section, you'll learn traditional fixed time horizon labeling and its limitations, and then you will learn to label the data based on the path the price takes. This uses an interesting approach called the triple barrier method. Finally, you'll be able to download all the code used in the course from the downloadable unit and practice on your data. Let's get started.